Yes, I am here sitting in the dark, and it is symbolic of where the church is in regards to racism. The Bible says that no flesh is going to glory in the presence of God. And if color of one's flesh validates their worth over someone else's, then we are in error. When Jesus Christ died on the cross, he died on the cross and he brought us back into right relationship with God. And when he brought us back into right relationship with God to make us one with God and whole within ourselves, one within ourselves, he brought us the privilege to go beyond the veil. And in that we have our reality or the revelation of who we are in Christ Jesus. That oneness in Christ Jesus gives us the power to walk in unity one with another. Therefore, if you say you love God and hate your man, the truth is not in you. And God wants truth in our inward parts. The truth of Christ in us, the hope of glory, Emmanuel. But if your self-worth is built on, I am better than you, then you're because of my color, or my sex, or how much money I make, whether it's elitism, sexism, racism, or any isms that causes chasms and chaosisms in our country. The church, walking in unity with one God, one faith, one love, can dismantle all that. We can be the door to bring in peace and unity into this world, but we first have to admit and deal with racism within the church. And until we deal with the racism in the church, to know that the church allowed men to be put on ships, they blessed those ships, they turned their backs at the lynchings, and even the Constitution by Christian men was written without regarding African Americans, without regarding their slaves as human, called them 1/8, playing God. God created all men. They decided that the man that God created was 1/8 man, and it was okay to treat him unjustly and not walk in mercy. That the church has to repent of. And that is the foundation of our country that is in error, that we have to rethink what we allowed and promoted and brought an illness into the country. See, a country divided cannot stand. And the church that is claiming God and Jesus Christ has to walk in unity. So the revelation of what Jesus Christ did on the cross and the privilege that we can go beyond the veil, go boldly and receive mercy and help in time of need, that church must be a people called by God's name and must repent and ask for healing for the land. But we first must walk in unity, one with another. Until then, we are in the dark, or maybe the twilight zone. Let's come into the revelation of what Christ did on the cross when he made us one again with our God, our Father, and what he did when the veil of the temple was rent and twain, and he says, it is finished. Let's enjoy the finished work of Jesus Christ and walk in unity with God and with each other. And come on out of this darkness and be a light to the world so they can see how to be free in Jesus.